One of the few constants of the Trump presidency has been Hope Hicks. She has been most recently the president's communications director, but she announced this week that she's resigned. I have some fresh reporting about when she's leaving and why she's leaving.
I think there is always a tendency on the part of a president's loyalists to look at negative coverage and say they're picking on him. But the difference is, first of all, you have a big counter press. If you think back to Watergate and wonder what would have been like had there been a Fox News, a Breitbart, a Hannity pounding away at the press for being biased and liberal and leftist, you wonder whether or not it would have developed quite the same way.
Would it have?
I write alternate history, but I don't do predictions.
Okay.
This coverage, which sometimes sounds, both on this network and others, like, we're one step away from the feds coming to arrest the president for something.
There are 100 stories competing for our attention, which there are. We just got to Friday on our list of headlines here. Isn't that benefiting the president or benefiting the people that might be under investigation? You know, talking about these various agencies where there's been exorbitant spending. There's been all these stories about embarrassing scandals in various departments. And yet, if they don't stay on the banner for more than 5 minutes, don't those people benefit?
Yeah, I do think it's a kind of case where, you know, every 15 seconds, it seems, the spotlight swings somewhere else. Some of these stories, I think, really require, from a substantive point of view, some sustained attention. And yet, every 15 seconds, it's almost like Tinder. You know, we're swiping right and swiping left every 10 seconds for the next hot story.
We wanted to take a look at what all these explosive headlines added up to and how we can all, as consumers, make sense of it. So we went ahead and looked at the chyrons, that's a term for the cable news banners on the bottom of the screen, and we picked out just some of the banners that appeared on CNN this week. It's going to take more than 3 minutes to go through all these. We'll slow it down for you in a minute, but I just want you to think about how fast they're going by, how much news is piling up on the screen. I mean, we're barely to the middle of the week at this point. It's Wednesday now, and I'm exhausted. I'm overwhelmed just taking a look at the list. Doesn't it feel like we're drowning in news? Doesn't it feel like the number of scandals, the number of allegations of corruption, the number of new developments about the Mueller probes, the number of stories about White House infighting, that it's all just too much to keep up with? And if so, what should journalists do to help? What can viewers and news consumers do to keep up? I think that's the conversation that we need to have at a moment like this, where it really does feel like the White House is in a rolling, ongoing crisis. Now, the banners are still going.